November 29, 2007, was yet another hearing in the prolonged trial of the coup d'etat case against the Magdalu Group. But it was not to be. Before the defense witness General Danilo Lim could be presented, Antonio Trillanes, fresh from the mandate he had received in the May senatorial elections, walked out of the courtroom.
Did you feel that, you know, you could have died there, that your life was in danger?
At that point, to be honest with you, it never crossed my mind, because what we're waiting for actually was those people who promised to defect and join us.
The whole picture of the plan to topple the government has yet to be told by Trillanes.
What would you acknowledge that you did wrong, if there were any? San kayo nagkamali?
Well, tactically, of course, everybody saw that, the fact that you failed. You can honestly say that there were some tactical blunders. But morally, whether that was the right thing to do, yes, it was. Tumupad kami doon sa aming commitment. Natitindig kami at this day and hour chosen, and we did. Pinanindigan namin, and it may look clumsy for some, pero yung iba ho ang nakita nila, yung puso. That ganito ang kaya namin gawin para sa inyo. So kahit ganyang kalaking kalaban, titindigan namin yan.
At may mga ibang grupo na gano'n ang kanilang pangako sa inyo o commitment sa inyo na naiwan kayo na kaliit-liit na grupo.
Ang role namin is to stand up. We did. So yun mo ang nakita, hopefully, ng taong bayan.
Antonio Trillanes IV, or Sonny to friends, was born on the 6th of August, 1971 to Estelita and Antonio Sr., a graduate of PMA class 1959. In the beginning, his father did not want his son to follow in his footsteps.
Why? What did he see you as?
Just like ordinary teenagers brought up in Manila, we tend to be laid back or just busy ourselves with the fun stuff. Gimmick lang dyan, or you date people, mga ganun lang.
Being raised in military camps, Trillanes was enamored by soldiery. He defied his father and took the PMA entrance exam. Trillanes was in his fourth year of college, taking up electronics engineering, when he entered the military academy. There, he was elected by his peers to chair the honor committee, which he now likens to the impeachment court.
We have this honor code that the cadets do not lie, cheat, steal, nor tolerate those who do. So those are the tenets of the honor code. So if you violate any of those tenets, you get to face the honor committee.
Trillanes graduated cum laude, belonging to the Marilag class of 1995. In his annual is a simple dedication, "Your vision, my mission," where he was described as a simple man with a big dream. Despite a brief career in the Navy, Trillanes had a five-year sea duty. In 1998, he was part of a daring search and rescue mission, retrieving 32 survivors from the ill-fated MV Princess of the Orient at the height of a super typhoon. He was duty officer at that time.
We went out, and I'm glad that we were part of rescuing 30, and hopefully this 30 survivors are living good, honest lives right now.
But out in the field, it didn't take long for disillusionment to set in.
There was this one incident when I was in the southern seas. In some area in Mapun Island, we apprehended this smuggler, this smuggling ship. And I was the watch officer then. So it was a dilemma for me, because I was just recently assigned aboard ship, And here are these two senior officers asking me to just turn a blind eye with what happened. So eventually, when I objected, they found a way to overrule my decision and still release the vessel. And that became a norm. Why are we patrolling the seas anyway, when every time we apprehend these people violating the law, somebody would just intervene and ask them to be released? It's the same when we caught illegal aliens in Ilocos Norte, poachers in Batanes.
As procurement officer of the Naval Training and Education Command, Trillanes was awarded for instituting reforms which resulted in savings of more than 4 million pesos. It was also the first time he was offered a bribe.
It was in an envelope, which I rejected.
By whom? A supplier?
A supplier, yes. So I told her, instead of giving me that money, why don't you just subtract that or take that off your bid price, and you'll actually get the project without having to bribe anyone. Mm-hmm. But apparently that's their system, so that they want to monopolize or corner all the projects.
Instead of being hailed, Trillanes was eased out.
They sowed intrigue, then when that didn't work, they filed a case against me.
The commanding officer told Trillanes to go on study leave instead.
But did the Navy pay for your studies, or was that out of your own pocket?
It's out of my own pocket.
So, fin-reaser ka, in other words. Parang ganun.
Yes, I was just studying.
Was that difficult for you to do? Was that, were you angered by it, or did you see it as an opportunity for self-enrichment?
No, I was ambivalent about it. I just saw that as a way of getting out of my previous unit, because not only was I unwelcome anymore, and it's also quite far. It's in Zambales. But when I got to attend the master's program, it got quite interesting. And suddenly, all those juices have been revived once again, and I became more inquisitive.
While completing his master's degree in public administration, Trillanes was being investigated for plotting against the Arroyo administration.
In fact, I was even escorted out of the classroom in UP at the time, when we were still being investigated on.
Mm-hmm. You were picked up by the PSG?
No, some intelligence units.
Now that you are in a position to push for reform that you have been fighting for from the outside, have you seen any improvement?
Yes, I'm very, very optimistic under this administration. And immediately after I was released, we pushed. Of course, we were very active during the investigations, just to show the extent of the problem, so that they'll start to appreciate the magnitude of the problem, and we can start formulating the solutions. So that's where it begins. Then after that, I strongly lobbied for the reclassification of the MOOE of the operating units, and to change their auditing requirements from being strictly financial auditing that required receipts and all that. This time, it's just a certification that would allow them flexibility to spend the funds in order to accomplish the mission.
Did your companions in the Magdalo, or are they enjoying any positions in government? I mean, how are they now?
Well, everybody has a job. That's the status right now, where everybody is accounted for. And right now, some are assigned in the PDEA, some are in Coast Guard, some are back in the service. Most of the enlisted men are back in the service. They have restored their ranks that were taken away from them during the time of GMA, and the others are with me in my office. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Are they not enjoying any juicy positions?